Books provide the ability to group together one or more reports, books, and other documents to generate a single PDF or Excel output. You can optionally include a customized table of contents using a Word document with a table of contents definition. You can also add common margins, page headers, and footers to a book. You can run reports for multiple member selections. You can use sections to group multiple documents under a common table of contents entry and run reports for a common POV. The focus of this tutorial is creating books. For more information about sections in books, please view our tutorial, Working with Book Sections in Narrative Reporting. Let's begin by navigating to Books and creating a book. Under Select a Folder, select the library folder that contains the artifacts you want to add to the book. The available artifacts are visible in the pane on the left. Supported artifacts are reports, other books, and Word and PDF documents. I'll select the income statement report and move it to the selected pane on the right. Notice that the data source is set automatically. You can use Control or Shift click to select multiple artifacts. In this example, I'll also move the Revenue by Territory report to the selected pane. I'll leave Create Default Section unselected for now. Click OK to open the Book Designer. In the Book Designer, you use the Book point of view to select members to run for a book for reports, books, and sections where the POV dimension selection is set to Current POV. Use the Content pane to add, delete, and move items, as well as define the POV for sections, reports, and inserted books. Use the toolbar to switch between edit and preview modes, save the book, open page setup, and validate the book's content. For a selected artifact or section, use the Properties pane to view general information, set the table of contents display, and set responses to prompts where applicable. Let's preview the book. Note that the book has two pages, one for each report. Change the book POV to view different data. Click the Edit icon to return to the Book Designer. Use the Node Actions menu for the root node to add artifacts, sections, or a table of contents. I'll demonstrate adding a table of contents later in this tutorial. Use the Node Actions menu for the report to add artifacts, sections, multiple artifacts, or a table of contents above or below the selected item, and delete and move items. Let's change the book POV from segments to children of all segments and select display suggestions only from the actions menu. Preview the book. The children of all segments are available for selection in the book POV. Return to the book designer. Keep income statement at current POV so it uses the end user selected book POV, and set revenue by territory to all segments. Preview the book. Note that individual artifacts can be driven by the selected book POV or selections at the artifact level. Note, to display multiple artifacts for the same POV and group the output by POV members, use sections. Return to the book designer. Add a table of contents to the root folder. Select a cover page and table of contents document from the library. Note, you use a Microsoft Word document with an inserted table of contents which was previously uploaded to the library, to define the formatting and layout. The Word document can also contain additional pages with content, such as a cover page and blank pages before or after the table of contents. Move the cover page and table of contents document above the income statement. Preview the book to view the generated cover page and table of contents. Return to the book designer. You can use text functions to modify and refine the table of contents display for a report, section, or book in TOC headings. Select income statement and modify the table of contents. Repeat for the Revenue by Territory report. Preview the book to view the results. Return to the Book Designer and select Page Setup. Add page numbers to the footer. You can use the General tab to specify general properties for headers, footers, and margins, such as the page number to start numbering pages, the document to begin adding headers and footers, and so forth. You can use the Margins tab to specify margins. Validate the book to confirm that the reports and books inserted in the book exist in the library and that all POV selections in the book are valid. Preview the book to view the page numbers. You can view and download the book as PDF or Excel. Let's preview the book in Excel. Notice that the artifacts are displayed in separate worksheets. Save the book. Check the description for links to related video tutorials. To learn more, visit docs.oracle.com.